Today we're going to tie the hare's ear nymph. The hare's ear gets its name from the material it's made from, the hare's ear. The fibres are stripped off of the hare's ear and dubbed onto the hook shank. They come in all various types of shades through dyeing, etc. The hare's ear nymph is used at deep water, specifically imitating the larvae and grubs that are on the bottom of the reservoir. We've chosen the long shank 10 because the fly needs to have more material, more bulkiness, because we need to represent the larger larvae on the bottom of the water. We're going to start the process of tying the fly by first whipping on with our black tying thread. Take the silk as before, touching turns right the way down the hook shank till we reach the bend. In this case, because we're building a bigger body on top, doesn't need to be quite so tight touching turns. So when we reach the bend, just drop the bobbin holder and trim off the waist. For the tail, we take some pheasant tail fibres, about half a dozen. Place them on top of the hook shank, approximately a quarter of an inch away from the bend. Hold with the left hand, bringing the silk up, we tie in those fibres. Just release and see that you're happy with the tail length past the bend of the hook. Once you've done that, take the silk back down, binding that tail fibres on top of the hook shank until you reach a quarter of an inch away from the eye of the hook. Reason why we're keeping further back this time is because we've got to build up a bigger thorax at the tail end of the fly. So we've tied our tail neatly in there. We then take some oval gold. This is going to form our rib. Tie in the oval gold and take the silk back down to the start of the tail. When we've reached that point, just put the oval gold in the material spring out the way and trim off the waist at the eye end. We then need to form our body. This will need to take a few small bunches of hare's fur fibres. Just dampen the fingers and spin onto the silk. You can use wax, tacky wax, but you end up with more on your fingers than you do on the actual silk. Once you've spun that on there, slide the fur up to the point of where the tail starts. Take it over two or three turns. That's catching the first few fibres in. Then we need to spin this without letting go to form a nice string type rope on the silk. When we've done this, we can now start to form the body. Take the body material over the hook shank. As you can see, it's much more bulkier and fluffier than the previous pheasant tail we've done. As you can see, we haven't got enough material to continue down the hook shank, so we need to add some more. Same procedure again, just dampen the fingers, twist onto the silk. Slide up to the shank. two turns to hold in, and again form that rope by twisting round without letting go. Again, fold round, forming a nice heavy body with that fur. Repeat this until you reach the point where you started the whip on. Okay. We then take our gold rib. We need to bring that as the pheasant tail opposite to the way we spun on the hare's fur. Nice even segmented body coming down to the silk. Just catch that in two or three turns. Trim off the waist. Tighten up with a couple of more turns to secure that nicely at that point. Now we need to form the wing case and legs. Again, center tail fibers from the pheasant tail. A larger bunch this time, up to a dozen tail fibers. Place on top. At this stage, we don't need to go the full length of the body. Just keep it back half an inch from the point where you tie it in. Secure that in nice and tight. Trim off the waist. For the thorax, take another small bunch of hair fur. Repeat the process of spinning that onto the silk. This is going to form that blob of a thorax, slightly bigger than the body at that point. Dub that on. Do a bit more there. Creating that bigger thorax that we require. We then bring the pheasant tail back over, forming the wing case. Then split those. Now what we've got is legs back, folding them towards the bend of the hook. Once you've got them folded back, build up the head, taking the silk towards the bend of the hook to keep those legs forward. Increase the head so that you've got a nice finish there. Now we can whip finish with the whip finish tool. As I've said previously, this ties a nice knot, keeping everything secure. Secondary knot to make sure trim off and varnish the head using the dubbing needle. Making sure you clear the eye of the hook. The dubbing needle, as it's called, we've dubbed on there. We can use the dubbing needle to just prick out the hair fibers between the rib to give it that bulkier, leggy, scruffy nymph type appearance. And there we have the finished Hares Ear Nymph.